escaping domestic drama for choreographed talks down under.
Australia strictly comes on.
But UK ministers unable to shake off the COVID party controversy at number 10, and new reports Boris Johnson's opponents have faced intimidation.
Are you aware of any instances of blackmail within your own government?
I do not have any information about what's happening on the subject you raise.
Much to say, though, on Russia's latest power move.
We urge President Putin to desist and step back from Ukraine before he makes a massive strategic mistake.
Strong rhetoric making international headlines.
We need everyone to step up. Together with our allies, we will continue to stand with Ukraine and urge Russia to de-escalate.
Australia is offering assistance, but with caveats.
To be clear, that is not about direct military support. That is not on the table from Australia's perspective.
Ukraine's Canberra representative telling SBS World News just what's at stake.
We hope and we work for better in order to avoid the worst case scenario, the full-scale invasion.
What help has Ukraine requested from the Australian government at this point?
Probably cybersecurity might be the most relevant in this situation.
Ukraine's hoping Australia can provide expertise to help it repel the cyber attacks that have hit a number of government departments in recent weeks. But that's not without risk and could invite cyber blowback on Australia.
There's limited policy bandwidth in Canberra. And if we allocate too much of it to a challenge in the Ukraine, we could be distracted from keeping our eye on the ball on issues in our patch.
It takes, I think, many countries to come together to call out that behaviour.
The price of liberty is eternal vigilance.
The cost of speaking up, itself a balancing act.